हेलो एवरीबॉडी, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन दी फार्मा इग्नाइट चैनल ऑफ एलजी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी। माई सेल्फ परेश पटेल, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेडिसिनल केमिस्ट्री एट एलजी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑटोनॉमिक नर्वस सिस्टम विच इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ सिलेबस इन मेडिसिनल केमिस्ट्री ऑफ सेमिस्टर 4। Now in this lecture I am going to give you the introduction and ideas about the how autonomic nervous system work, which are the different neurotransmitters, which are the physiological responses, and which are the adrenergic drugs which are used in the treatment of certain diseases. First of all, we need to know okay, what is nervous system. In general, if you consider the nervous system, it is of two types: central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system include brain and spinal cord, while peripheral nervous system is again divided into two parts. One is somatic nervous system and autonomic nervous system. Now, somatic nervous system is related with the skeletal muscle, but autonomic nervous system is again divided into two main parts. One is a cholinergic nervous system and another is a adrenergic nervous system. Cholinergic nervous system, as its name indicate, its function is controlled by the primary neurotransmitter of acetylcholine, while in case of adrenergic, the primary neurotransmitters, they are noradrenaline, adrenaline, and in some of the cases the dopamine is also there. Now we can see the effect of different neurotransmitter on the different regions. Postganglionic transmission, acetylcholine, norepinephrine, and dopamine, and which are the effectors or on which particular organs these neurotransmitters are producing their actions. They are cardiac and smooth muscle. There is also a sweat glands. Then we have also the nerve terminals. We have also the renal vascular smooth muscle and blood veins. Now, we need to understand before going in the detail about the effect of the different neurotransmitters. We need to understand certain words which are commonly used in the autonomic nervous system. Presynaptic neurons. What is the presynaptic neurons? It is a place where a neurotransmitter is synthesized, stored, and that is released upon the cell activations. So you can say it is a home where the neurotransmitter, they are synthesized, also they are stored. They release only when there is a cell activations through the different mechanism. What about the postsynaptic neurons? They are the place where the neurotransmitter, they are detected, and their action is translated into the different cellular activities. And what is synapse? It is a junctional connection across which the signal can be passed. So it is synapse, again you need to understand very properly. It is a junctional connection across which a signal can be passed. And ganglionic transmission, it is a cholinergic and it can be blocked only by providing the ganglionic blockers. Now, if we see the differences upon the sympathetic and cholinergic system, both are opposite to their action in most of the cases. The properties of the sympathetic nervous system is they have the property of adjusting the response in the stressful situations like a trauma, fear, and exercise. Stimulation of the sympathetic system will result into the increase in the heart rate, increase in the blood pressure, and mobilize the energy store of the body. They are also responsible for increasing the blood flow to the skeletal muscle. The parasympathetic nervous system, it maintains the essential body functions like a digestive process and elimination of the waste product. And as I told earlier also, both the sympathetic and cholinergic, they are producing their action opposite to each other. Now, very important one, okay, which are the different receptors on which this neurotransmitter producing their actions. And at the same time, when we are providing the drugs, either as an agonist or antagonist, they are also working on this particular receptor. As you know that the agonist are increasing the response while antagonist are decreasing the response. Now here we have, if you see the cholinergic system, the acetylcholine working on two primary neurotransmitter, they are nicotinic and muscarinic. And muscarinic are again divided into five subtypes: M1, M2, M3, M4, and M5. So M1 to M5, these are the sub-receptors of muscarinic. In case of nicotinic, they are again divided into two parts. One is NM, that is nicotinic, which is working on neuromuscular junctions. And NN means they are working on the neuronal junctions or the ganglion. Adrenergic system, that is adrenaline and noradrenaline, they work primarily on two type of receptors, that is alpha and beta. Alpha is again subdivided into two parts, that is alpha 1, alpha 2, and beta is subdivided into beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. Dopamine neurotransmitter is again working on five different dopamine receptors, that is D1, D2, D3, D4, and D5. Now we will understand how the adrenaline and noradrenaline, they are synthesized and how their metabolism is taking place. Phenylalanine is a precursor from which the tyrosine is biosynthesized. This tyrosine is converted into the DOPA, which is abbreviated as dihydroxyphenylalanine. So dihydroxyphenylalanine is DOPA, and that tyrosine is converted into DOPA with the help of enzyme tyroxine hydroxylase. This DOPA is converted into dopamine with the help of enzyme aromatic decarboxylase. So aromatic decarboxylase enzyme convert the DOPA to the dopamine. This dopamine is converted into norepinephrine or noradrenaline with the help of enzyme dopamine beta hydroxylase. That means there will be the introduction of hydroxylase group or hydroxyl group OH. And norepinephrine or noradrenaline is converted into epinephrine or adrenaline with the help of methyl transferase. So the difference in the structure of the adrenaline and noradrenaline is only the methyl group. Nor indicate the absence of methyl group. So in noradrenaline there is no methyl group, which is methylated and converted into adrenaline with the help of enzyme and methyl transferase. But this enzyme is present only in adrenal medulla. So the conversion of noradrenaline to adrenaline will only be taking place in the adrenal medulla only. The nerve terminals cannot able to convert the noradrenaline to adrenaline. You can see the image how this dopamine to noradrenaline and adrenaline, they are taking place. And after this synthesized noradrenaline and adrenaline or dopamines, they are releasing and working on their receptors through the, but that require the activation, as I told earlier in this lecture only. They are released from the their nerve terminals through the mechanism of exocytosis. So through the exocytosis mechanism, these noradrenaline or adrenaline or dopamine, they are released. These release adrenaline and noradrenaline or dopamines, they are again metabolized by the very two important key enzymes, which are known as COMT and MAO. We'll see later on. Adrenal medulla is containing more amount of adrenaline than noradrenaline, because that adrenal medulla is the only one where the noradrenaline is converted into adrenaline. The rate limiting step, very important one when we talk about the competitive exams, tyroxine hydroxylase is the rate limiting step where it is converted to the DOPA. Then major inactivation of most of the neurotransmitters, they are highly by the reuptake mechanism. Now, how about the metabolism? Epinephrine is metabolized by the COMT enzyme and they are converted into metanephrine. And this metanephrine, with the help of MAO enzymes, MAO is abbreviated as monoamine oxidase, while COMT is abbreviated as catecholamine O-methyl transferase, which is converted into VMA, that is vanillin mandelic acid. Epinephrine is converted into DHMA, and then again with the help of COMT enzyme, it is again converted into VMA. Even norepinephrine is also metabolized with the MAO enzymes through the DHMA and converted into VMA. So ultimately, VMA is the end product the metabolism of the particular metabolism of adrenaline and noradrenaline. Major metabolites for both the we can say epinephrine as well as norepinephrine, they are the vanillin mandelic acid. And some of the few traces of the noradrenaline and adrenaline, they are also excreted unchanged in the urine. MAO, as I told earlier, it is a monoamine oxidase, and COMT is catecholamine O-methyl transferase. Different location of the receptors of adrenergic and cholinergics, adrenergic systems, they are alpha 1, alpha 2. Where they are located, alpha 1 are mainly located and responsible to mediate the vasoconstrictions of the coronary arteries. They also produce a dilation of the pupils, which is also known as mydriasis. Alpha 1 blockers like phentolamines and prazosins, they are the alpha 1 antagonist. Alpha 2 are clonidine, which is as an agonist. They working on the presynaptic and inhibitory in the nature. Beta 1 mediate the increasing in the heart rate, increasing the heart contractility, which is also referred as positive ionotropic actions. They also produce the positive chronotropic effect, that is increasing the conductance velocity. They also increase the cardiac output. They mediate the lipolysis, and they also mediate the renin release. While beta 2 receptors, they are responsible for the bronchodilations, decrease in the GIT motility, mediate the glycogenolysis, produce the relaxations of the uterus and relaxation of the skeletal and coronary blood vessels.